My name is Naveen Kumar. So in this video, we are going to focus on have forms. Before we begin the topic have forms, let me remind the topic do forms, which we have completed in our last class. Do forms, do has three forms, do, does and did. Do and does are used in present tense. Did is used in past tense. Do is used with I, you, and plural subjects. Does is always used with singular subjects. As it is, as like do forms, here have forms also can be used in present tense and past tense. Have also has three forms. Have, has, and had. Remember one thing. We can use have forms as stative verbs and dynamic verbs. We already discussed what is a stative verb and what is a dynamic verb. Stative verbs always describe situations or states. Dynamic verbs always describe physical activities. Okay? So here, have. Have is always used with first person, I, second person, you, and with plurals in present tense. Has is always used with singular subjects like he, she, it, etc. Had is always used with both singular subject and plural subject. But when do we use have? I mean, in which tense we use have, has and had? Right. So here, have is always used in present tense. Has is always used in present tense. But had is always used in past tense. Okay, right. There are a few examples for you to use have, has and had in different situations and in different tenses. Here is the first example. We have a car. Here, we have a car. I have used have along with we because the subject to we is in plural form. That's why I have used have there. And we have a car. This is not a verb. Of course it is a verb, but it doesn't describe any physical activity. It gives us some information about ownership. So if you want to talk about ownership, use have form. I have a car. She has a pen. They have a ball. These are all ownerships. That means they own something like that. We have a car. That means we own a car. So here, have used as stative verb. But in the next sentence, I usually have my lunch at 1 p.m. I usually have lunch, my lunch at 1 p.m. But here, have is not a stative verb. In the second statement, have used as dynamic verb. Here, have means nothing but eat. That means I usually eat my lunch at 1 p.m. Instead of eat, I have used have in the place of eat. Okay? So, I usually eat my lunch at 1 p.m. So, I usually have my lunch at 1 p.m. In the first statement, have used as a stative verb. In the second statement, have used as a dynamic verb. That's why I told you that have can be used as a stative verb and a dynamic verb. Now, has. Has is always used with singular subjects in present tense. Bruce has a wife and two kids. Yeah, Bruce has. Why did I use has here? Because the subject to Bruce is in singular form. Bruce, singular one. That's why I have used has. Bruce has a wife and two kids. She has. He has. It has. Bruce has, Tony has, Lata has, Sita has, because all the subjects are in singular forms. Now, had. Had is also used with both singular and plurals. But remember one thing, we use had in past tense only. That means if you wanted to talk about past experience or if you wanted to say something about past, use had there. She had a car. She had a car in the past, but she doesn't have any car in the present. If you want to talk about past, use had. She had a car few years ago, but she doesn't have any cars right now. Okay, right. This is about have forms. But remember one more thing. We can use have forms to make affirmative statements or simply positive statements, like which we have written on the board. And we can use negative statements also by using have forms. Have you finished your work? That means I have completed my work. If I didn't complete my work, you can say I haven't completed my work. When you use have forms, use V3 along with the have, whether it is in negative form or positive form. Like I haven't, that means have not. I haven't finished my work. That means I didn't complete my work. So I haven't finished my work. She hasn't completed her work. Okay? Right. So you can make negative statements also by using have forms. And remember one more thing. You can make questions also by using have forms. Have you completed your lunch? Has she finished her work? Have you gone to the movie? Like that. So here we can use have forms to make affirmative statements, that means positive statements, negative statements, questions. Okay, so this is about have forms. Okay, I hope you understand. If you have any doubts, you can post in the comment section. I will try to clarify your doubts. So this is about have forms. Okay, thank you so much for listening to my class. Please like my videos, share my videos, and subscribe.